Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Put God first.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We're
going to hear another song from the choir. And
we're
coming to give the offering.
Amen. Very good, invite.
Yeah.
Tasoma kwenye kitabu cha Mwanzo.
We're going to read in the book of Genesis.
Sura yake ya 4.
Genesis.
Mwenye kwa karibu ataanza kuiandaa.
The person that is close and ready to start.
Atatusomea hapo ndugu Francois kama uko karibu unaweza tusomea.
Francois, if you're ready, get ready for it.
Kichwa chetu cha leo ambacho tutakachozungumza Mwanzo sura yake ya 4 kuanzia sura yake ya kwanza. Le mstari wa kwanza. Tutazungumzia juu ya utoa.
We want to talk about giving.
When you understand, labda ungejua significa.
A lot of people say, if I know the
country. Kijana naye anaanza vitu ya kutoa.
This young man has started things of giving.
Anataka zekeshi.
He's about to get himself money.
Lakini tutajifunza jambo moja juu ya kutoa.
Today we need to start on the way of.
Karibu ndugu kama uko karibu. Mwanzo sura ya 4.
Giving, that's offering. Genesis 4.
Utaishia kwa 7 pia.
Amena. Naye akapata mimba, akamzaa Kaini. Akasema nimepata mtoto mwanamume kwa Bwana.
Amen.
Akaongeza, akamzaa ndugu yake Abili. Abili alikuwa mchuma kondoo.
Amena.
Na Kaini alikuwa mkulima ardhi. Ikawa hatimaye Kaini akaleta mazao ya ardhi sadaka kwa Bwana. Abili naye akaleta wazao wa kwanza kwa wanyama wake na sehemu zilizonona za wanyama. Bwana akamtakabali habari na sadaka yake, bali Kaini hakumtakabali. Bwana sadaka yake Kaini akakadhabika sana uso wake akakunja mana. Bwana akamwambia Kaini, kwa nini kuna ghadhabu? Na kwa nini uso wako umekunjamana? Sawa. Kama ukitenda vyema, utapata kibali. Usipotenda vyema, dhambi yako inakuotea mlangoni. Nayo inakutamani wewe, walakini yapasa uishi.
Amen. Amen.
May God bless you, brother.
Tenda vyema.
If you have done well.
Tuko mkiwanza.
We in the field.
Historia ya mtu tunataka kusoma.
The story that we just read.
Ni kubwa mtoto.
Is the brother.
Walizaliwa na mtu huyu.
They were all born by one.
Baba huyu. Mama mmoja. Inafika wakati
hii. He gets to retirement.
Kila mtu ana kazi yake
ambayo anafanya.
Ikafika wakati akatolewa na mtolea
mwingine.
Kila mtu alipoa vile alivyosikia
mtu. Everybody wanted to give according to what.
Lakini watuambia sadaka ya mmoja kachukuliwa.
But the Bible says.
Ya mwingine ikachukuliwa.
The first the one.
Mwingine akachukua na hasira.
And another one took with
him. Biblia nasema hata sura yake ikakua ikakunjamana.
The Bible says even his face showed
anger. Ikafikia mpaka atue kutikia
ndugu yake. And he got to the point to hate his brother.
Ikamua mpaka amue ndugu
yake. And he decided to kill his brother.
Na uamuzi ulikuwa wake
mwenyewe. And that decision is wrong.
Ndani ya kanisa.
In the church.
Tuko pia na uamuzi.
We also have to.
Unisikia mzuri?
Yes.
Ndani ya kanisa.
In the church.
Tuko na uamuzi.
We have to.
Ndani ya kanisa. Tuko na kisuma.
We have to.
Ndani ya kanisa. Tuko na wajambazi.
We have the gangsters and all that.
Nani anaweza kaniambia definition ya mwizi ni nani?
Who can define a thief?
Mwizi ni mtu gani?
Thief. Define him.
Yes, mwizi.
Define.
Ukisikia leo mtu ni mwizi, alikuwa ni mtu wa
aibu. You hear someone say thief. What does that mean?
Kisuma. Eh? Ingali kwa hiyo. Kisuma mwizi ni moyo. Asante. Mwizi ni mtu gani? Karibu
mwizi. Mtu gani achukua vitu vya wengine bila kuomba.
Bila ruhusa. Asante. Kuna mwingine?
Thief is the person that takes people's stuff without asking. That's not what's happening.
Mwizi, kama vile ndivyo amesema, ni yule anachukua kitu cha mtu bila ruhusa. Ama mlipatana na mtu kitu fulani, wewe unaenda kando ya kile kitu bila kumjulisha yule mtu. Anakuwa mwizi tayari.
Ndani ya kanisa tuko
hivyo.
Also in the church like that.
Tunawapatana fulani tulipatana. Lakini
but
tunamuiba kama mtu.
We are still in God's word with that man.
Unaweza kusema mimi niko namuiba Mungu na mna gani?
You must ask yourself, are you stealing from God?
Kila siku naombaka.
Every day I
ask. Kila siku nafanyika kila kitu.
Every day I do everything.
Sasa namna gani mimi nitai?
How I must steal?
Sadaka.
Offering.
Sadaka.
Offering.
Tunamuiba Mungu kupitia ndani ya sadaka.
We are stealing from God through offering.
Sadaka.
Offering.
Ni kitendo cha roho. Imani ya
it's an act of spirit.
Unakugusa tu,
it only touches you.
Unaenda na mtolea.
And you go on and give to God. You go on.
It's
not your own.
Yeah. ana wengine maskini wanaye.
He has other poor people than the other one.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Utoe tu ile moja ambayo unayo.
Give it to one.
Patia mtu mwingine.
Give it to another person.
Na hiyo pesa hiyo
ni yako. It is for you.
Unapozisha shamba,
unalima shamba. When you farm.
Yeye anaendelea kukubariki.
He keeps on blessing you.
Unafunga mifuko.
When you.
Yeye anaendelea kukubariki. Usiangwe na sala ya kwanza, ya pili.
Second, he just looks at
you.
He doesn't touch
you.
Once the goat
gets
there, and I start counting, he is one for me. So we
need to.
When we get there, that's when we forgot. The one that you give him, that is your blessing. The tenth that you give him, it is saving your
money.
That's why you say that my money is not there.
You will not
pay for it securely.
The tenth that I give him, it's
saving for my own money. Death cannot come and touch
you.
And of course, it is also secreted for your death.
What does it feel?
Amen. So we
even
forget to do that. We are not able to do that.
Chakumi.
A tenth. It's a blessing.
Chakumi.
Those that were
given.
They went and gave to God. And they said, the one offering was taken and that one was not taken. It was a personal choice. But when they gave, it was very bad for them. The offering was not taken to God. You will see me when I come and give my offering. I come all the
time.
You must talk what you give
me.
Talk to God again. I'm giving you this.
It's
you that give me
this.
Don't just give your money to
God.
When you give to God, no, what you feel is coming through your offerings.
How about
here?
You
ask yourself, the most important thing of
God is
the church is
there.
You are giving the church. Don't go to work. We must always continue. If you know, we are not going to have anything.
Amen.
We're going to see
Sadaka
an offering of a witch. We want to do
it.
We want to do this.
We
want to do this. We want to do that. That's another different.
Sadaka hiyo.
That. That's the offer
when
the crew is. And he says, Andre, I'm going to pay
$500. Pastor
Ivo,
$500.
Your job is
to take your
job.
So that's
for me. You would think I've given to Calgary.
When I say I used to
give it to Calgary,
I'm
going to give it to
Calgary.
He said, oh, really? If you set your money
out,
you give it to Calgary.
God
is going through the world. But most of us, we give promises. It's already in the same way. Will become. Without giving conference, it can become a. We are promising to God, but we're not doing the same
thing.
You give yourself a meditation. Everybody reads. They get jobs, but they
don't have money.
It's already. My blessing is not
coming.
Amen. Mama, you should eat your child. Please sit down so that you can hear this. That's the offering for our gathering.
Sadaka.
There is also an offering. That's every Sunday's offering.
Sadaka.
This offering.
Sadaka.
This offering.
Ya kila Sunday.
Of every Sunday.
Si sadaka ya kusema
this is not for us to go and build the church.
We give.
We give offerings. How again are they going to ask us to pay for
church?
The offering
is
his. He has his own job. What is his job? That brother. If he was a
pastor,
that's the money that's
going to pay for.
So that he can go.
The
boy wants to go
somewhere.
That's the money that's
going
to
pay for.
To pay the church now. Church must be. That's when we're blessing.
Sadaka hii.
This
offer.
When we give.
Sadaka ya kutumikisha watumishi.
It's for.
Waende wafanye kazi.
To go.
Kanisa
niende
wakwaya.
The church and the choir.
Lakini sio hii.
It's not for this pastor to write to another. If that's what we're doing, then we're going backwards. That's not the church. I'll give you an example. Our brother in
Jehovah,
they don't have this here. They don't have. They only have like a box in the back. And that is our offering for them. Those that come, 1 million. You see the novels they do every
year.
You see the places they
live in.
Because they have
to have
money. And that is why
it's
the offering
for us.
What do we have that is so
better?
Are they giving the money for the pastor, but it's for God's work? It's just like the time.
You're the Mutumishi when you're poor.
The men
are the ones who are
praying for you. Because he's praying. So he has to dance. Amen. We're also going to see the offering of Sunday. A promise. The offering of a promise. You promise to God.
Baba,
me God. If you give me this. This wife, I am going to give you this.
Baba,
God, if you give my wife
to
me,
Father,
if you help me,
I
am going to give you
this.
God, I have my
own.
I'm going to give you this. You have already promised God. He is hearing very fast. And he does fulfill. Amen. He is listening to wait to your ways. God, is this the reason? Okay, that's why I won't do that. You want this? Yes. He gives yours.
Finish.
This is your problem.
Kisha maliza?
I'm done.
All of them,
I was so smart for them
then.
And you can forget
them.
The man of God that I give request for him to pray for you, you can forget them. And that is the offering that you promised to God.
I
promise to God and the voice of God also came
out.
And I said to
Ibrahim,
Turkish man.
When
to them in a forest. And Imran was like, what's this?
This is not a good thing.
Go through a man that is
and
the Bible says, in the early days, left them in the forest.
Isaac,
the voice of God also came.
Baba,
God, but
Father,
listen to what I'm saying. Take your
children.
Go and give him offering to me. That's another question.
Mama
Andre, take Andre and go give him.
Send
it to
him.
This mother of mine has no
intention.
I only said, Mama, come here. She did not go against
me.
She came. The first time I said,
now
they're telling me, take care. Go and give him offer. What are you going to do?
I'm going to
give him offer. That is good.
That is good. Do
you know what I'm going
to do? I don't know. I can't
be there for
you.
It was a very big thing.
Ibrahim
and Abraham and told his wife Sarah, I want to give
myself.
That mission had failed. The wife would have
gone,
but he said, it's God that has said, then it has gone. He said, I'm
going to give it to God.
And he asked the wife, what do you have? And Abraham was. And also the son asked, Father, I'm touching wood, but I don't see
what we're
going to give.
What
I have and just going to the Father, wait, wait. You see that? God, when you bless someone, you can say, Andrew,
you
have shoes. I'll give another shoes. No. God blesses where there's gaps. Give what you have, give what you have, and then the
best.
There's no place for
this. That's
what you
imagine,
because of that gap that was already there.
Isaac
also one was given. It was also an equation. When they go to the
mountain,
and he begged his child. He prayed, he cried. He
says,
if you read through it deeply, and you see you see, then your own child, your son, with a knife. Imagine to my mother and even if the blood hasn't come, the mother
will
come. You see that? Even if the blood
has
come,
the mother
will come. She will be locked up for everything. For five, if you
can.
Because the intentions of
the
but he said, probably not
care.
I want to give
it to my
God. If it's worth, he's the one that gave me, and I'm going to give him back. Amen. We are stuck there. God gives you. And then you say, it's a God of grace. No, it's not God for that. God is not that. If he tells you do this, do that. I was walking in town to us. We were with my mom. We went for Palestinian. And my father. Father says, Mama Andre. Don't worry, God is giving us food we're going to eat. They started going against themselves. When we go to that place, if my grandpa gives you a story of food, He says, my friend, if you go upon the mountain, you will see the presence of God sitting far. That's what the chicken that was there, the food. Do you guys have a kokoriko book with chicken?
Kokoriko ni hile hewa na teke kama chonga. Bala hecha mboga. Sali wabu ya mba kiteka kusharne ya bali. Kipika tongocho hiu. Yesu kuna kukitia mbaga huu. Na ukipata kukweli
netu nipewe hiu. Let you go to the mountain of the fufu wa give it.
Nipo armaka chansa. Kiu. Kina sarafa hali. Tuliko pika wababa na mama pale.
Where we go there? Mother and father.
We
heard the person just said, oh, please come here, there's a food. Mama was asking,
Papa Wesu,
I
don't
know.
Thank you. My man.
That's in faith.
Tulichapata ugali.
We ate the food there. God gives you blessings that you don't have. You have promised to God what? What have you promised to God and He has never done to you?
What
have you promised? He hasn't done. How many people have
asked God
and He did not fulfill it? This. This is the most important one. You see in church. They said in church today we're going to give this kind of offering. You see, just blinks. That's the first mistake. The offering to go and say you're going to ask my wife. If you can touch for $1,000, don't worry about the
cost.
If you say, I'm going to ask my husband, that's not a negotiation.
Abraham
I'm going to say, that's not offering no more.
It's
better than give 100. And the other one should close
that.
It's also going to be different. Offering. I'm going back
again.
Offering blesses you. Let's not be like Cain and Abel.
Cain.
What killed the mistake? What I started with. The
time.
If you start that,
where you're going to go on the chair,
and you go give me
food, Kaini,
and Anania right there died. This is not for the
altar.
This is this. Is this only God bless
you?
Yes, this is what God bless you. And right there, she died. The altar is
there.
You see those
people?
Those are the ones that are. Is this one thing that you sold? Yes, yes. And right there, all of them died. You see the miracles of God. You will not see the point of the time. When we're in Burundi, the man of God was
preaching.
And was saying,
the
tenth is
to do it.
And people started giving. And he got down to his. And that brother. He had his money. Do you hear what I'm saying?
$600.
And he came and gave $600. He had $600. And he gave $600. And it was still there. After the service. A big wallet like this one here that was $540. So $540 was lost. The man went to the You are the one that.
$60 Na itoa.
And again.
Godo yangu ni mana ukanisa.
I wanted to install it in the church.
Una siki papa sera ba ako kaya wa bimu yako wa
hakika ba.
Mule ni tanda ya kuya.
You tell my father.
Mishon kwa na mambia ba.
Eh, the man of God.
Izo pesa ni sako kwa Yesu tumikia.
Eh, the man of God. Is this your money?
Lisa. Na wakati ni mobili.
Eh, usu. Eh, when.
Nikasema hai chale ni kutolega.
I said, let me go give.
Na chule wakati ni kuja.
And that's the time I can give.
Misha ni mambia.
And the man of God says.
Na mbili utola kutu.
Just go and I'm sure
I'm
in the morning. The man of God also Yesterday I went to the man.
I gave here
$60.
Ikafika jana.
And yesterday,
before
we
leave,
my wallet was lost.
Even this is not
the same. Well,
now
I'm talking. Just looking
at
my wallet was there.
Naive.
I give another $100.
Amen.
That's what the tenth does. He saves the money. What he gives you
guys.
Who received it? Do you really give your tenth? If you do, do you have promises that you really give to God and enough that is not
fulfilled?
Don't think this is a right
thing.
I was giving
you one.
We are three. We were going to ready. One girl came to the gas station. Are you guys Christians?
I said, yes, we're
Christians. I'm selling my bus lift. Very good van. Can you get a van? If you guys are men of church, you can really write your own name there. We will hear you. This will be hard to be transporting people. We left from where we went to where the conversation we had. This is a
message.
So we can just go on and look for one van that we can actually have. So the idea that
came
until now, why did we leave the idea? And today I've brought the idea to you. I've brought the idea
to you.
Because the promise God gave us $2,000 so that we can work for God. Are we all angry now? If we do it or not? If there are those that are here and they want us to do this first. One fund for $2,000. And say to God, if it's your $100, you give it to God. Give me half of that. If it's my $20, I'm starting my school tomorrow. I'm starting school. To finish my school. Promise to God and see if God is
not going
to do it. Don't do it. Because everybody has said, give a $2,000 and God is
going
to do it. Who's going to be the first to actually go on and fulfill the promise? The first person is the one that is
all
the
blessings.
Even if it's $20, give
it.
Who's going to be the first? The one's van that we're going to do for the grace of Christ. So that we can leave a gap and God fulfills it. We leave
them.
The grant
is transferred.
If you're going to come, you can leave. I'll be the first. I'll be the first to take it. I'll be the first. Amen. Amen. God has funny
happens.
I only have one bottle of
water.
Or small. Which I'm going to eat tomorrow and this night. But see the blessings that you receive. Why you have given today? They will do.
mwingine atakayesoma ile
logo is a very
is it yako yako
every person that is going to read
grace
Christian fellowship
grace
Christian fellowship it's not other person, it's me or you that cause for that. It's your own.
May you
God do the best things. Let's not
stop.
And let's not stop. Let's start giving our
time.
God gives you the life to give. I don't have
anything.
I want to give it to my God in my heart. I already had to give my God a
and they cool.
One of us.
Oh, yeah. God that my husband is here today. And I just wanted to say bye. Today's my last day. But anyways, I'm going to call up my husband so we can sing a song.
I'll be, you know, no.